Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Bog CNC Works. This is Nugent. Yes, it's been a minute since I've recorded the video, but hopefully today will make up for the couple of weeks that I haven't uploaded. Today we're going to be doing Norton White Tile method in combination with your Lightburn image tools. I'm going to be using Stucky, Jarvis, pass through, and then I'm going to be using Stucky on the Norton White Tile method itself. So first of all, let's start with drawing a rectangle. My tiles are 198 millimeters by 198 millimeters. I love drawing them out like this. It just helps with the alignment. Then we can go through to Google. I just went to Pexels to get a image for free. You just have to give thanks to the person who created it or uploaded it. In this case, I can't pronounce that, but Mr. Centena. I'm just going to select the medium. The larger ones make the uploading time much longer. So I'm going to give thanks by just copying this and then pasting it into the description so that you can go to Pexels and support this creator. I'm going to go to Image R, scroll down, click on upload, and we want this one. It's the medium one. As you see, I have already downloaded it, but for the video's sake, I'll download it again. Okay, let's just wait a couple of seconds for this to get uploaded. Okay, as you can see, my internet is pretty slow here in South Africa. But I will scroll down. There's the picture. Now we will just crop it. I'm going to be doing rounded square crop. Going to round the edges. And I'm going to do, just to see in millimeters. Scroll up. Yes, that's what we want. Want the face, a little bit of the blur, some of the shirt in front. Let's just scroll down, click crop, then Image R will do the magic behind the scenes. I really love this. Go down, just click resize, put it in millimeters. Don't want it that large, just want it 100 by 100 millimeters, because I'm going to be doing four on that single 200 by 200 millimeter tile. I'm going to be doing 318, then clicking OK, and it's going to convert it to how I want it. Then this one, you'll see your current size and everything, and you'll see on the left hand side you can come, you can do a bit more editing, but I just leave this alone. Just go over. Now for the Jarvis and the Stucky, I'm going to be just downloading this photo as is, as a PNG. Just click close on this ad. See, download it. I close this one, but I'm still going to go to material. I'm using a diode laser, a Ortur Master Laser Master tool, the 15 watt. Then Norton White Tile, click OK. And they do a bit more editing in the background. And then your picture ends up like this. This is the, you see, your laser will be burning away the white paint, and then just concentrating on the black spots. So that's what you want. And that's why we are doing this comparison today. Now I'm going to download this. Also as a PNG. And then once it's done, just click close. And always click restart, not to leave your images on the server. Makes it slower. So just do the right thing. Then we go to our laser. Open a downloads folder. As you can see, this is the first one that is just basically black and white. I'll post it here. Just go and position it. See, put it on the black layer for image. Now the first one, I'm going to go with Stucky. See, it's on 317. Then I'm going to re-upload it again. Remember, this is only the ones that was basically turned black and white by image R. So this one, I'm just going to be moving it to the blue layer. Double click it. We will turn this one to Jarvis. Okay, and then we go take the one that the Norton White Tile method was done on. See, it differs just a bit. I'll just put it there again. Go off, just move this one, this one onto it. Shall we? 99 180, that is why. Let's just make this 198 as well. Always double check your settings. Let's move this down. Now this one you want on a red layer. This one we're just going to put pass through on. See the difference between them. We're going to take this one that the full Norton White Tile method was done on. Just going to put it there. I've done this before and I know it sounds a bit crazy, but I'm going to do the Norton White Tile method, then pass through off, and just going with Stucky just to see how it will look like. Now let's just put top left, just make it smaller, make this 10 millimeters. S for Stucky. S for Stucky. Then we put J for Jarvis. Norton. N for Norton. N for Nugent. And then Norton Stucky. Okay. So now we have to go through our settings. So you see mine is on 1500 millimeters per minute and at 80 power. Now this is something that you can take this the speed and power as a starting point for yourself, but I will link to a video right here top right hand corner on how to get the best settings. So yeah, 1580 works for me. Doesn't mean it will work for you. It happens. Just make sure constant power is off because it really affects it. Okay, everything is fine. Just do this one, 317. Just check the DPI. And that is it. Now you're probably wondering why I put this black, this black square on top of it. Black square just helps me position my tile perfectly every single time. If I move, if I'm this Ortur Laser Master 2, yes, they do have homing, but they differ with 2 to 3 millimeters sometimes if you go back to the same position. So I decided I'll rather do this. So the next clip will be of the tile engraving, and then after that be cleaning the tile, and then we will go through and just see the comparison between the 4 different methods. I hope you are enjoying the video thus far. Please like and subscribe if you feel like I've given you some knowledge or just something that you can work with. Thank you.
I just took some warm water, put in some dish soap, and just washed it with brush, and then afterwards just using the plastic part of the brush just to like scrub it off, and yes, that way it will come off easier. Then the final photo is just as how it looks when it's done. Basically. So if you liked it, please like and subscribe. See you in the next one.